Hi, my name's Joe Elling. I'm with Metropolitan Mosquito Control. I've been working with the drone program for about 4.5 years now. We started using small drones for mapping and kind of capturing some photogrammetry, and it quickly branched into getting the bigger ones for some treatments. We have 3 treatment drones. We have a PV-22, which was our first drone. We have the Agrass T-10, and then we actually have the bigger brother of this, the Agrass T-30, for some of our bigger sites. So we'll actually get the motor started.
Aircraft preparing to take off. Stand back at a safe distance.
Take off. Pick it up. But this newest one that we've been trying out, it's kind of perfect. Perfect size for what sites we're treating. It's not as loud, so it doesn't annoy the public as much as some of the bigger ones. And it's got all the safety features built right into it, so it's really nice, and it's been working great.
We've been treating some wetlands with the drone back behind you. It was about 2.5 acres that we just did. With Altacid P35, which is a larvicide we use to treat for mosquito larvae. Essentially, we have the option of either using pre-planned files that we can get off of our GIS software.
Once we get to the site, we unload the drone and use our pre-calculated amount of material we need to load into the drone. Load shapefile, which should be loaded through the computer, but if not, we have the option of drawing it onto the controller.
And it's super easy. All we do is pretty much just outline the site with a couple of waypoints, and then the programming takes it from there. It just draws a bunch of lines that are parallel to each other. We can adjust the width of the route, the width of the lengths, essentially.
And then the direction we want the drone to fly in, and where the drone could start and end.
You can add buffers. So this one has actually a buffer around a house. So you know that the aircraft won't be treating anywhere near that house. All the yellow lines is where it actually will be treating. And then anything shaded there is the actual polygon of where the material is going to be dispersed into it.
We have to make sure we have enough batteries charged up for the day. So we'll start off charging the batteries some, make sure we have a good set of a couple sets of batteries so that we can get out and hit a couple sites well. We're there to make sure that everything's done right.
Even those smaller sites, you know, it's easier just to park the drone on the road. It takes us maybe 5 minutes to set up, take off, fly it, another 5 minutes of treatment, it flies back. That's what, a sixth of the time it may take a field tech to the site?
The site that we're standing next to now, historically, is one that's just difficult for a technician to walk through with a backpack. And so we were, in past years, failing to get adequate, even coverage across the whole site. So with the drone, not only is it able to give us even coverage, but the drone, it gets a little more material and a little bit better coverage.